Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, December 12th, 2012. It is 9:10 a.m. New York time as I speak. You're looking at a Euro-USD 4-hour chart on a Wando's MT4 trading platform. And the first thing I want to highlight is this 1.3045 area. Notice how earlier this month it seemed to influence price action on this pair. See a high there, see some lows here, and lows there as well. So this 130.45 area has had a notable effect on price action, and the euro earlier, just in the past hour or two, has topped out near 1.3045. Actually, you'll see in a moment, I'm going to show you a shorter term time frame, and you'll see the euro has reached its daily M4 pivot point just above 1.3050. Now, before I move on to that 15-minute chart, I want to highlight this move up this far this week. The dollar has been persistently weak, the euro, and to some degree, persistently strong. Now, why is that? Well, we got the one reason, perhaps, is the FOMC. We've got the Federal Open Market Committee. That's the group representing the U.S. Federal Reserve, the U.S. Central Bank. They're due to announce their latest decision on monetary policy about an hour after London close, specifically 12:30 p.m. New York time is when the FOMC statement is due. You could argue that this rise in the euro-USD, or more specifically the weakness in the dollar, is on the back of expectations that the U.S. Federal Reserve is going to announce some form or forms, perhaps, of additional monetary policy easing. And by the way, notice we've almost, the euro has almost recouped its losses from last week against the dollar. You might recall about here, this was last Thursday, during last Thursday's New York morning session, ECB President Mario Draghi, in response to a question from a reporter during the ECB press conference, interest rate cuts discussed amongst the governing council, Draghi mentioned a wide discussion about interest rates before the governing council decided to keep rates where they were. Well, that reference to a wide discussion put notable pressure on the euro. And you can see the euro dropped Thursday and during part of Friday's New York morning session. Well, the euro has recouped nearly all of those losses following the Draghi comments. And more specifically, last Friday, we did see reports that not only Draghi, but several of the key members of the ECB reportedly have objected to a rate cut that was apparently discussed amongst other members of the governing council. So the euro has recovered, perhaps, on market realization that maybe a rate cut isn't a certainty from the ECB. You have dollar weakness on the back of expectations that the Fed is going to do some form of additional easing. And so it's, you know, given all that, it's not crazy, certainly not crazy to look to short the dollar, specifically to look to buy the Euro-USD during the course of today's New York morning trading session. Let's take a look at a shorter time frame here. Here's a 15-minute chart for the Euro-USD. Again, it's almost 9:15 a.m. New York time. Notice that near the middle of this chart, I've got two horizontal lines, one at 1.3025, one at 1.3030. See the hesitation in price here and here earlier today. The prospect, what you're facing here, if you're looking for a euro long, perhaps we would get a lower high formed here around 1.3045, which I mentioned earlier. There's a daily M4 pivot point, which we topped that out about an hour ago or so. So what the possibility here for the euro bulls, perhaps we turn lower here and return to that 1.3030, 1.3025 area, which affected price action earlier, presenting the case for a long. Now, there's more to it than just that. I don't show it on this chart, but at the moment, we got a 15-minute 21 EMA part near 1.3030. Also, if I do a FIB study of the move up, specifically a Fibonacci study of the move up from the low near the bottom of the chart to the high near the daily M4 pivot point, I see a 38.2% FIB retracement level of that move up. Let me highlight that with a drawing tool. 38.2% FIB of the move up. Hang on a minute. 38.2% FIB of the move up from here to there. That 38.2% FIB is just a smidge above 1.3030. Also noteworthy, the 50% FIB of that move up sitting just below 1.3425. Again, the 1.3025 level did seem to affect price action earlier. So for the euro bulls, certainly a prospective green zone, a prospective buy zone around 1.3025, 1.3030 area. Prospective profit targets for your bulls. If you get a buy there, and if you can manage to move higher today, move above a ceiling for pivot point. I recall we have a daily R2 pivot point near 1.3070. And if the euro really runs before the FOMC statement due out at 12:30 p.m. New York time, perhaps if the euro reaches 1.31, the psychological level again at 1.31, you have another profit target there as well.